lot of bookmakers. Bookmakers desperate to get Slate House out of the frame.
But Colin Tizard has already struck. Bookmakers may be desperate to get Slate House out of the frame, Martin, but will they?
He's a horse that very much will divide opinion. His form has come in small field races. He's got to go and prove himself in the competitive handicap scenario that he finds himself in today. I think this race is short on progressive horses. There are quite a lot of exposed horses at the bigger prices that would be hard to fancy. And so from that point of view, you can understand why the untapped potential that he has and the lightly raced profile that he has is quite an attractive one. But we touched on pre-racing, the fact that that mark of 147, it's kind of Bruce Forsyth's play your cards right a little bit higher or lower depending on the handicapper that you take.
Where are you going?
I'd have gone lower, I think. I think Gara de Jouy last week at Wincanton, I know he didn't run his race at all, but he kind of bombed out completely, never went a yard. Did he beat much? I'm not sure he did. I don't think any horse really up against him last time gave the running.
Let's join Dave.
Yeah, Sam Boswell joins me. It's really about this Slate House, is it? Looking at your phone, it doesn't look good.
It's still going lower and lower in price. 9-2 now with ourselves at the moment. It's the only one really being backed at the front of the market. There's a few each way nibbles going through a little bit bigger. Springtown Late still 9-1. That was well backed this morning as well. Happy Diva 14-1. Dave, I know you're a big fan.
Yeah, but it's a big drifter from what I can see. But bookmakers might be wishing the rain had stayed away. It kept on coming. But Nick is back in the paddock.
Cheers, Navo. So, Martin, not too much time. Where would you like to concentrate?
I mentioned earlier, Bellamy de Picton, I think, is his profile is an all-or-nothing one because he bled the last time we saw him. We've not seen him much over the last couple of years, but he certainly has the potential to be well-handicapped. We will get a strong pace here, there's no doubt about that. Cyrus de Lac, heart on sleeve, jumped really well out in front. Count Mirabel lining up handy. Mercian Prince is another one who's always up there as well.
Lizzie Kelly's only had a dozen rides since May, coming back off a broken arm. What a comeback ride it is. Cyrus de Lac, aboard whom she won the Ultima at the festival. A plate, I should say, at the festival.
Yeah, exactly. Warthog as well, Springtown Lake. There are others you can see lining up towards the head of affairs. We've got Guitar Pete in there, the grey horse at the back. He was third in this race last year. He is a little bit higher in the weights now.
And he's won one of these. He won the December edition of this a couple of years ago as well. Eamon and Koenig was fourth in the plate. He looks as if he's going to get a waiting ride. His stable companion, Warthog, Springtown Lake, Mercian Prince, Us and Them, Count Mirabel, all lining up as though they're going to have a go. Past winner of the race, Splash of Ginger's come for a bit of money at a prize.
Yeah, and this strong pace that's likely could suit Spirit of the Game. Jonathan was keen on his chance earlier on.
So they're about to come out then for the 2019 running of this Bet Victor Gold Cup. £160,000 for the feature this weekend, to be called by Ian Bartlett.
They race away then. They have 15 fences to jump, and as they race on towards the first of those, Cyrus de Lac and Warthog amongst the first ones, from Splash of Ginge and Count Mirabel, Eamon and Kernock, and Slate House for the last couple of runners over fence number one. Guitar Pete is not far behind the leaders, and then comes Us and Them and Springtown Lake as they get to number two. And Bellamy de Picton, problems there. We've lost one right at the back of the field as well. Rider is just about to sit up and they run on towards number three. And it is Eamon and Kernock, number 15, who went at fence number two. Slightly, I think, interfered as well with Bellamy de Picton in the yellow colours, is a little way behind the others. They run round the bottom turn for the first time. Cyrus de Lac leading from Warthog in the orange in second. And then Mercian Prince close up in third. The blue jacket, a Splash of Ginger's next, from a red cap of Count Mirabel, and the second of the greys, Guitar Pete. Behind him is Spirit of the Games, the red and white checks of Springtown Lake towards the running rail. Braylon Dar is with him, and then Us and Them, a red and blue jacket, a white cap. Towards the left is Demi Song, the best turned up winner, Highway 101 in white and red, just precedes him as they jump number four. Magic Saint is next, and then Happy Diva towards the inner running rail in the yellow and purple jacket. The red and white of Slate House still towards the rear, has just Bellamy de Picton, blue spots on yellow behind him as they take the fifth plane fence, which they were all over safely. And Eamon and Kernock, the loose horse, galloping wide of them as they run down to two more plain fences in the straight. Cyrus de Lac and Lizzie Kelly leading. David Noonan in orange on Warthog in second. and then Mercy and Prince, Jack Quinlan in third, Guitar Pete, one of the greys towards the left, Splash of Ginger and Blue Colours is with him, as there, another one down is Highway 101, unseats the rider. Horse and rider are both okay, so Highway 101 is out of the race. They have a circuit remaining as they make their way towards number 8, and Warthog has joined Cedar du Lac in front. Count Maribel, Mercy and Prince, the Splash of June, Spirit of the Gains behind these from Happy Diva and Guitar Prince and Utton Them, and then comes Braylon Darfur and Demi Seng and Magic Sane and Springtown Lake, and they're followed by Slate House, who continues to be last but one. Bellamida picked on in the yellow jacket, the one behind him, as they make their way now on towards another plain fence, number 9 coming up before the water jump, which they take only once. The orange of Warthog, the maroon and yellow of Cedar du Lac continue to be the leading pair. Count Maribel, Guitar Pete and Mercy and Prince in behind them as they take this plain fence. They head to the water now. Splash of Ginger's next, and then Spirit of the Games, the green, red and white colours from Braylon Darfur and Us and Them and Magic Saint and Demi Song as they take the water jump. Behind those was Slade House, Springtown Lake in the red and white checks has lost places. He's with the yellow colours of Bellamida picked on at the rear as they come now to the first of the open ditches where Cedar du Lac and Warthog continue to be the leaders. A terrible blunder from Springtown Lake at the rear of the field. I think he'll be pulled up. Five from the finish now as they run uphill, and it's Warthog just the leader. Two in second position. Splash of Ginger's been pulled up before taking that plain fence. So Splash of Ginger and Springtown Lake are both out of it. Three from the finish. The final one on the top of the hill now, the last of the ditches. And it's Warthog, Cedar du Lac, Count Maribel very close now to those in third position, trying to take second. Mercy and Prince is next, followed through by Happy Diva. She's jumping well in the yellow and purple, has taken fourth. Braylon Dar, noseband, it is next. Spirit of the Games is in company with him. Then Magic Saint and Slate House, who's beginning to get closer. It's a long run now before they leave the ground again. Us and Them from Bellamida picked on and a weakening Guitar Peter, the next group of runners, as the orange colours of Warthog heads down the side of the course, and he skipped on by two lengths. But Happy Diva, Richard Patrick in yellow and purple, is out after him. Cedar du Lac is still there. Count Maribel with a red cap, the noseband then of Braylon Darfur. Barry Geraghty against the running rail, making significant progress. And then Robbie Power on Slate House is getting closer. Spirit of the Games is next. Magic Saint is behind that. And then comes Bellamida Picton. They're still running on towards the home turn. Warthog has raced prominently the whole way through. He's about a two-length leader from Slate House in the red and white on the left. Look at him coming there. Braylon Darfur, and also with those is Happy Diva. And as they level to the second last, there's four in line. Happy Diva in the purple and yellow. Slate House fell at the second last. Braylon Darfur is into second. Warthog in third. Count Maribel is left in fourth. Happy Diva leads to Braylon Darfur, but only just at the last obstacle. And now the noseband of Braylon Darfur trying to get to Happy Diva, but she's fending him off. Richard Patrick in the yellow and purple, and Happy Diva still in front. Braylon Darfur is trying hard in second place, but Happy Diva is still holding in. They race towards the line. Happy Diva, yes, she's done it. She won by a neck or so to Braylon Darfur. Warthog is next, and running on for fourth position was Bellamida Picton from Magic Saint and Count Maribel.
Well, poetic justice for Happy Diva, who becomes the first mare to win this race since Lady Cricket in 2000, gives Kerry Lee her biggest success as a trainer. Richard Patrick, his biggest success in the saddle. It might have been oh so different had Slate House stood up two from home. There's a disconsolate Robbie Power walking back. How well Slate House has run. But Happy Diva was going nearly as well, if not as well, at the time. And she'd been going very well when coming to grief in this very race last year. A rare blip on an otherwise oh so consistent record. And she's really deserved a big one, and she's got one.
Tremendously consistent and game, isn't she? And this was her seventh start in a handicap chase. She'd nearly won previously in handicap chases, but she hadn't. And yet, come the biggest day of all, this is her toughest handicap chase that she's been in yet. She goes and gets the job done. And she did beat last season in the listed mares chase at Huntingdon, the subsequent Grand National runner-up Magic of Light. So she has some strong form to her name. It's a really game and gutsy performance, but you've got to feel for connections and supporters of Slate House, because he was coming there tanking along and looked for all the world like he was going to go and win well.
The runner-up, Braylandin, has run a career best, and by some way, and no doubt about his heart for the fight today.
No, and also his stamina, because that was definitely under question, and he's pressed the winner all the way to the line.
Kerry Lee, that first season was full of high points, but you know, I would still maintain this is her most high-profile success.
Yeah, and this mare gave her probably highlights in a very tough campaign last year. She went through the doldrums, really, through the midwinter last year, Kerry Lee, but the horse is back fit, back healthy, and, yeah, a really important win for that team.